Hello friends, welcome to Physics and Animation. In today's video, we will understand the concept of electrostatic potential energy for a system of charges. To understand this, let's take a positive charge Q1 from infinity to a certain position. Let's assume, anyhow, we fixed the charge in this position. Now, when we want to bring another charge Q2 close to the charge Q1, we will need to do work to overcome the repulsive force of the positive charge Q1. Okay, now let's imagine that we have somehow bound these two charges so that they cannot move. So the work we did has now been converted into potential energy. If we release Q2, this potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy and the charge will start moving. The same thing will happen if we release charge Q1 in a similar manner. Even though we did work on Q2, not on Q1. This behavior helps us to understand the concept of potential energy in a system of charges, where the energy doesn't belong to either Q1 or Q2. It always belongs to the system of charges. So the total energy of the system will be work done W1 to move the charge Q1, which is 0. But we had to do work to move charge Q2, that is W2, and this is not 0. Now, if we want to make another charge, Q3, a part of this system of charges, we will need to do even more work than the last charge. This is because in the system, the both charges are now repelling charge Q3. As we keep adding charges to the system, the potential energy of the system increases. And to make each new charge a part of the system, we need to do even more work. In this way, we can create high energy system of charges by adding numerous charges to it. Now let's dive into the mathematical aspects and derive the expression for the potential energy of a system of charges. To understand this, let's first consider charges Q1 and Q2, assuming that Q2 is a distance x from charge Q1. Initially, we can assume that the distance between Q1 and Q2 is infinity. We know that the Coulomb force F21 between two charges is given by F21 equals 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 divided by x square. This means that to bring charge Q2 close to Q1 to a distance R21, we will need to apply a negligibly more force than this so that we can bring the charge slowly and steadily towards Q1. Generally, we consider the applied force to be equal to Coulomb force. Now, we know that the work done from infinity to R21 will be the dot product of force F and displacement S, which will be Fs cos theta. In this case, the displacement and force have the same direction, so theta becomes 0 degrees. Therefore, we are left with Fs. Since we are moving the charge very slowly with a displacement of dx, we can consider S as dx. Let's replace the force F with Coulomb force F21. And integrate it between R21 and infinity. We know that Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught is a constant. And the integration of 1 upon x square is minus 1 upon x. And we can bring the minus sign outside. Using the upper and lower limits, we get 1 upon infinity minus 1 upon R21, where 1 upon infinity is 0. So we are left with 1 upon R21 and the minus sign taken outside will become positive. Finally, we have the equation for work done from infinity to R is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R. And this complete work done, which was done to bring the charge Q1 from infinity to distance R near Q2, is the same as the potential energy you stored in the system of these two charges. So, now we have the equation for the energy of a system of two charges. Now, using this equation, we can calculate the potential energy of a system of three charges. Let's understand this by bringing another charge Q3 close to Q1 and Q2, where Q3 is at distance R31 from Q1 and R32 from Q2. We will assume that Q3 has also been brought from infinity to this position. Now, it's time to calculate the mathematical expression for the potential energy of a system of three charges, which is quite simple. As we have seen before, the potential energy between Q1 and Q2 is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R. Using the same expression with some modification, we can write the potential energy between Q1 and Q3 as equals 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q3 divided by R. Similarly, you can calculate it for Q3 and Q2, resulting in a similar expression. Finally, by summing up these three energies, we will obtain the total energy of the system of three charges. Okay, now let's discuss the potential energy associated with a charge in an external electric field. Suppose there is a unit charge Q at point P, placed in an external electric field. To understand how much potential energy this charge holds in the external electric field, we first need to remember that if there is an electric field anywhere, it must have a source charge. Without a charge, there can be no electric field. This means that at some distance r from the charge Q, there must be source charge that is creating the electric field here. The potential energy of the system of the source charge and the charge will be expressed as U equals 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught source charge Q into Q divided by distance between the charge and the source charge, denoted as R. Now, we know that this expression represents the magnitude of the potential at point P created by source charge Q. So, we can replace it with capital V. Therefore, the potential energy of a charge placed in an external electric field will be U equals QV. If the charge Q is an electron, we can represent it as minus E. Therefore, for an electron, the potential energy U will become minus EV. And this unit of energy is often referred to as an electron volt. At the end, let's see some important points related to potential energy. When dealing with two positive charges, the potential energy will be positive and the force will be repulsive. However, if one charge is positive and the other is negative, the potential energy will be negative. In this case, the force is attractive, but the energy is negative. So that's all for this video. If this video really helps you, please don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching.